Now coming lecture number 2, I am explaining first aid for cuts and scratches. So last point was apply an antiseptic lotion to prevent infection after cleaning the wound. Next last point is cover the wound with gauze or bandage. Covering of wound prevents germs from entering the wound. And the last point is after applying antiseptic lotion, cover the wound. In first aid you will find gauze bandage also and adhesive bandage also. So cover the wound with gauze or bandage. Okay, gauze covering of wound. Prevents germs from entering the wound. Okay, if your wound will be covered with the gauze or bandage, germs will not enter into your wound. Okay, if you after applying antiseptic lotion also, if you are not covering your wound with gauze or bandage, then if germs will enter in your wound, there will be an infection and that infection will increase. Okay, so these are the first aid for cuts and scratches. Now I will go for first aid for nose bleeds. Okay, first aid for nose bleeds. Sometimes your nose will bleed. So what you will do in such case? So first is sit down and pinch the soft part of the nose just below the bony part for at least 10 minutes. During this period, breathe through the mouth. Okay, first sit down and pinch the soft part of the nose just below the bony part. Okay, if there is nose bleeding, then you have to sit down and pinch. Okay, pinch your soft part of your nose. Means say this is bony part, this is soft part. So pinch it at least for 10 minutes. Okay, pinch it for 10 minutes. During this period, you have to breathe through mouth. Okay, if there is nose bleed, pinch it for 10 minutes and breathe through your mouth. First point is sit down. Okay, and pinch your soft part of your nose at least for 10 minutes. Okay? Now during this period, breathe through the mouth. Okay, sit down, pinch your soft part of your nose at least for 10 minutes. During this period, breathe through your mouth. Number 2 point, if bleeding continues, repeat the process after 5 minutes. Okay, if after doing this also for 10 minutes, if again there is bleeding, then after 5 minutes, again repeat this process. If bleeding continues, okay, repeat the process after 5 minutes, okay, means if again bleeding is there, again you have to wait for 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, again sit down, again pinch your soft part of your nose at least for 10 minutes. Number third point is, once the bleeding stop, do not pitch or blow your nose or lie down flat. Do not pick or blow your nose. Okay. Do not lift any heavy object for the next 24 hours. Okay. Means once the bleeding stop, do not pick or blow. Okay. Do not blow your nose. Okay. Or lie down flat. Do not lie down flat also. After bleeding stop, do not pick, do not blow, and do not lie flat. Okay. Do not lift any heavy objects for the next 24 hours. Okay. So when the bleeding stops, okay, do not pick or blow your nose or lie down flat. Okay, when the bleeding stops, do not pick, do not blow, or do not lie down flat. Okay, so last point, do not lift any heavy object for the next 24 hours. Okay, first is sit down and pinch your soft part of your nose at least 14 years. During this period, breathe through the mouth. If bleeding continues, repeat the process. This process after 5 minutes. Now, when the bleeding stops, do not pick, do not blow, or do not lie down flat, and do not leave any heavy object at least for the next 24 hours. Okay. Now I will go for next topic, first aid for burns. Okay, first aid for burns. So come to next topic, first aid for burns. If the burn is severe, rush the victim to a hospital immediately. Okay, if there is a burn is severed, means very dreadful, then you have to run to the, you have to take that victim, take that person and run to the hospital immediately. Okay. In case of minor burn, do the following. If there is a minor burn, okay, if there is a severe burn, deep burn, okay. If there is a most dreadful burn, then you have to take that victim, treat that person and run to the hospital immediately. But if there is minor burn, okay, in minor burn, do the following. Okay, first, keep the burn area under cool running water for at least 10 minutes. This will reduce the pain and minimize swelling. Okay, keep the burn area under cool running water. If this area is burned, then keep this area, apply cool water, okay, at least for 10 minutes. Keep the burned area under cool running water for 10 minutes. Okay, this will reduce the pain and there will be minimized swelling will be there. Okay. Second, apply an antiseptic cream. The burn area can be loosely wrapped in the sterile gauze. Okay. After that, apply an antiseptic cream. In first aid you will get. Apply an antiseptic cream. And after that, apply sterile gauze. Okay, there is a bandage, you can apply it enough. If after applying this, there will be no jumping, it will prevent entering from for the germs. Third, do not prick any blisters that may form on the burnt area. Do not prick. Okay, do not. See, after burning, there is a small bubble in there, so do not prick it. Okay, do not prick any blisters that may form on the burnt area. Okay, if there is any bubble, that blister will be there, so please do not pick it. Okay, after burning, you will form a bubble, so do not prick it, otherwise there will be more problem in there, there will be more pain. So till now I am stopping with page number 42. In next classes I will start page number 43. So for now, goodbye to all of you.